with my 1 year physique body update that I'm calling the quarantine body update. It's been 3 years since I first started all of this. It's been 3 years and I'm going strong. We chilling, we good. So I'm mad excited. RJ's about to be 3 years old, obviously. And oh my God, y'all, like he is full of so much joy, so much laughter, so much just like, he makes me laugh every day. He is just a rambunctious, energetic kid, and I for real cannot imagine life without him. Like, oh, life without him, like, I can't. With that being said, we are potty training, and it's going. Without any further ado, let's get into my 1 year quarantine physique body update, y'all. Here we go. I'm really happy with myself. You know, I'm chilling. Like, I'm very excited and I'm very proud that this is where I'm at. Like, can I just tell you why I am so excited though? You know, and really like, okay, girl, that's what's up. This was during, we just moved. We just moved to our new house, and anybody know who's bought a house, you know that it's like a whirlwind. So between this packing up, between painting an old house, between cleaning a new house, between actually finding a home in general, you know, running back and forth with the realtor, running back and forth to drop the kids off when they did go to school and everything before quarantine. So this was like months ago. I'm saying all of that to say, we were busy. And I didn't have time to go to the gym. Like, going to the gym did not fit into everything that I was doing, and that was fine, you know. But I'm gonna tell you what kept me on track, what kept me consistent, was intermittent fasting. I said it, like, it is what it is. Intermittent fasting has really gotten me, it has had my back. Like, intermittent fasting, you know, I'm sure everybody knows about intermittent fasting. I don't, you know, want to explain something that obviously we all get. If you don't get it, let me know. I can explain it again. But without making this video too long, I just want to real quick talk about just the couple tips that I was able to just have for myself through this 1 year that has like really helped me. Thinking of intermittent fasting, it's just delayed eating. All you're doing is eating later in the day or at a window that works for you. It's just delayed eating. It's not that you can't have that cookie. It's not that you can't have that oatmeal cream pie. It's not that you can't have that mimosa. It's not that you can't have whatever you want. It's just when you have it. You're just delaying when you have it. And then my other one is, hunger is not the enemy. Like, you're gonna feel hungry, but it's okay to feel hungry. Like, it's all right to feel hungry. Like, you know, like, hunger is not the enemy in terms of, you know, oh my God, I'm so hungry. Like, oh, like, how can this be? Like, you know, it's okay. Like, if you're hungry, that's good. Sometimes your body needs a rest. And then the other tip is like just listening to your body, you know. So I know I say hunger's not the enemy, but also if you're really feeling uncomfortable and you're like, yo, I'm in pain, you know, if your body tells you that you need to eat at this time, make your window from that time to, you know, eight hours, you know what I mean? So listen to your body. Other tip is, are you really hungry or thirsty? I feel like that's like a very, you know, basic, that's what they always say. Are you hungry or are you thirsty? Is it psychological? Are you thinking too much about food? Like, if I think about food, I'd be like, oof, I want pizza, I want this, I want that. I can have it all. I want it all, you know, right here, right now. But like, that's because I'm just sitting there thinking about food. You know, if I just really focus on something else or do something else, then it turns into, I wasn't even really hungry like that for real. Like, I just needed to actually go do something else other than think about food. The other tip is that just in general, personally for me, why intermittent fasting works for me is because I'm a light eater, or I don't like heavy things on my stomach in general. So eating within that eight hour window, it feels like my stomach is not as heavy. You know, I'm not as sluggish. I'm not as like worn out in terms of just what I'm carrying. It's time for a break. You know what I mean? And the last tip that I have is just the fact that you want to give your body a break. Like, you want to give your body a chance to just kind of flush things out. You know what I'm saying? And just give your digestive system a chance. Give your, you know, your belly a chance. Give you the gases in your stomach a chance to just break some food down and have a break. You know what I'm saying? So for me, I feel like I feel that, and I feel like it helps so much. I hope this helped y'all. I am so excited to get this journey going. If y'all are interested in any sort of like home decor videos or declutter with me videos or, you know, gardening videos, check me out. Come follow me in this journey, our journey, walking with the walkers. We just got this new house. We're in quarantine. What else am I gonna be doing? I welcome y'all to just come join us, and thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see y'all in my next video. Goodbye.